Let's talk about analog horror.
So analog horror has been gaining popularity in the past few years, and it is a type of horror that presents itself solely through the use of analog media. These are things like VHS tapes, television broadcasts, phone signals. It's basically things that are in contrast to modern day digital media, which is media that's stored on computers in ones and zeros.
The more you know.
Analog horror fills this weird niche of unsettling that you can only really get when you hear the emergency broadcast tone start on your TV in the middle of the night, or you're watching an episode of a show that's been taped over so many times you can barely even make out what's being said anymore. I was first introduced to analog horror through Local 58, but projects like the Mandela Catalog, Gemini Home Entertainment, and Monument Mythos have brought it to the forefront of independent horror. And now, we finally have a proper video game that uses the theme of analog horror to tell its story, and that game is called Home Safety Hotline. To be fair, there have been other analog horror games, but they have been... how do I put this? Bad. At least in my opinion, most other analog horror games that have come out haven't quite hit this high of a bar yet. And Home Safety Hotline is the first game that I've seen that uses the analog horror style well.
I'm not me anymore. It took me. It took me. I can't see myself anymore. I'm gone.
The setup for the game is that it's April 1996. I am 3 months old, and the player has joined a company called the Home Safety Hotline. They take calls from customers that are dealing with various safety hazards in their home. And over the course of the game, you are given a database filled with entries of possible problems that your customers could be dealing with. Most of them are pretty standard household hazards: termites, cockroaches, carbon monoxide poisoning, wood secretions, bed hags.
Just a usual collection of your average, everyday, normal, very normal things.
You have to listen to the exact issues your customer is dealing with and match it with the appropriate household hazard. For example, if somebody complains that they're coughing, sneezing, and there's a black substance around the rim of their tub, well, they're probably dealing with black mold. Or alternatively, if a customer is complaining about the disappearance of a loved one due to them turning into a tree that oozes black liquid and wears their clothes, well, in that case, you got a sprig tree infestation.
I'm gonna be honest with you, that's some real spooky shit right there.
As you finish taking callers for the day, you unlock new information in the company's database. And each day, the possible hazards become more and more terrifying. All right, Puka. I don't like Puka. The game is presented entirely through a desktop that's reminiscent of Windows 95. And over the course of the game, more and more files will appear on your fake desktop to give you some more insight into the world of HSH.
Suspect is described to be approximately 6 feet tall, barefoot, wearing a large bush or shrub on their person.
I'm sorry, what? The first day is actually pretty simple, as there aren't any otherworldly terrors on the list of possible hazards to choose from. Your supervisor, Carol, calls you at the beginning of each day and gives you a rundown of your performance, as well as an update of going-ons in the company. Carol is also a wonderful manager who is 100% a real person and a very, very normal human being.
Park employee, lend thine ear once more. Supervisor Carol here again. I've updated thy permissions to grant thee access to all relevant household hazard information. Continue thy labors, employee. Soon thy time in the soil arriveth. Prepare thy body.
We love Carol around here. If you manage to go through the day and diagnose every single hazard correctly, you get a coupon for a product that is sold by HSH. Got my coupon, Haghide. Oh my god. Haggling for deals. Source cruelty-free from the perished and treated with our flower-scented formula. These are the best quality hag hides you'll find. This month only we'll throw in an Ire Wall Monk free of charge. Let the whispers keep your bed the safe haven it should be. Sleep easier, sleep safer. I don't know if I want that. I don't want to buy that. The second day is where things really begin, and you start to get new entries about threats. You also start getting some very strange calls from some very friendly-looking folks in your neighborhood.
Yo, Buzz Goober here. Been having a heck of a time over here. I got these snappers itching and whooping and crying all over the place. Snappers itching. Just all over the place I got these whippersnappers yelping and whining, and I can't get a wink of sleep. She's trying to lay down over here.
As a quick reminder, Buzz Goober is still on the run from authorities. If you see him, be sure to call 1-800- Oh my god, get this guy the fuck away from me right now, his face looks like it's melting. Or alternatively, our other number at 1-800-7. As the days progressed, and I thought I was comfortable in my position, the responsibilities began to pile up.
Last week, I called you guys about some weird noises I had coming from my living room, and the info package you sent me said something about leaving out a bowl of cream? What kind of joke is that? It's been a week now that I've been dealing with this racket, no thanks to you, and now we're starting to have power outages. Your employee's stupid joke is now probably going to cost me who knows how much in repair costs. So talk to your manager and tell them they owe me big time.
Gary.
You figure out what's going on in my house and you figure it out now!
Gary, you didn't listen. You had a common hob, Gary.
Please hold.
You had a common hob and you didn't leave milk out for it. Now you got a metamorphosis on your hands. You messed up, Gary. You should have listened to us and left the cream out. There are quite a few entries in the HSH database, and it can be pretty difficult to keep track of them all. Especially when some of them exhibit overlapping signs. Are those cracks in your wall from normal termites, or do you have a fracture hob? Occasionally, the database will even go offline completely, and you need to diagnose a caller's problem entirely from your memory. I sure hope you know what the fuck a neighbor's doorway is, because lack of database access is no excuse for giving the wrong information. And if you do end up giving someone bad information on something they're trying to deal with, well...
It didn't fix anything. Would you shut up? Daddy's on the phone! Why is your mouth bleeding? What are you pointing at?
Whoops. As it turns out, working for a company that deals with murderous entities from other dimensions might not be all it's cracked up to be. In the game's email system, you will occasionally get emails from an old employee named Mike. He apparently used to have your job, but things didn't go so well. And currently, he's hiding in the walls of the office building you're working at.
So what's the deal? What does it all mean? Does the game have a secret meaning behind it where it's actually about some kids that went missing in the 90s? Because apparently that's what every fucking analog horror game needs to be about for some reason?
No. Actually, it's all pretty straightforward. The world of Home Safety Hotline expands upon the lore of fairies or fey folk. Not like the family-friendly kind that grant wishes, more like the sad Polish kind that steal your children and replace them with a big mushroom. In the world of Home Safety Hotline, it's common enough that people come across things like gnomes, wisps, trolls, and pukas that the Home Safety Hotline needed to be created. I'll go ahead and give a spoiler warning for the ending right here in case you want to play it, which I do highly recommend. So over the course of the game, it becomes clear that the people running the company might not just be a bunch of executives trying to raise stock prices. Supervisor Carol, hi Carol, continually references you moving up in the company in very unsettling ways.
Hello, Supervisor Carol here. Thine accuracy continues to impress those of us above and below the soil.
After a week of work dealing with normal customers, you're given a final exam. Here, a man in a cloak repeatedly calls you and gives you a riddle about one of the entries in the database. However, the database that you've been using has been entirely replaced by images of you being buried further and further in the dirt. This means that you have to answer the riddles and guess the correct database entry entirely by memory. And there's actually two different endings you can get. If at any point you fail to meet the minimum correct number of responses for the callers, Carol lets you know that you're being let go from the company, but you do have a wonderful severance package. The package is, of course, that you get turned into a mouse. On the bright side, you can now go live with Mike in the walls. The other ending comes if you manage to actually pass the final exam.
Promotion in progress. Please stand by.
Our new junior supervisor! Oh my god, I'm just so glad to be given this opportunity from all you guys. Oh, Trisha, you're gonna get it next, girl. I just know it.
Yes, you get promoted to Junior Supervisor of the Fey Folk. Yes, the ending is very lighthearted and funny, and truthfully, the entire game's scare factor is actually pretty low. Yes, there's some unsettling moments, but it sticks true to its source material of fairies and mixes in a good amount of humor as well as creepiness. Analog horror has been one of my favorite genres recently on the independent horror scene. And while the sheer amount of analog horror content that is being created can make it a little tiring, I'm still very happy to see it when people come up with fresh takes on the idea. I wholeheartedly recommend Home Safety Hotline, and even if you got spoiled on the ending, I would recommend getting it just so you can read a lot of the database entries. There's a lot of really cool writing in there. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to go put an egg next to my toilet so I don't get kidnapped in the middle of the night. Stupid fairy bullshit.